Okay, so if you've read the title of the video, you've probably got a pretty good idea of what's in this box, but, oh, I don't have my knife. Clearly at this point, I'm filming the video, I haven't read the title, so you're gonna have to humor me as we come along on a voyage of discovery here. Okay, so we know it's from Intel Corporation. Could this be the plans for world domination that we ordered? I mean, what could be red hot rush? That sounds dirty. Oh. All right then, so let's pop the side panel on this, ow, puppy. There we go. And get a better look at what's gonna be pretty much the most generic damn computer I think I've ever seen in my life. But wait, maybe this is exactly the point they're trying to make. Maybe this 3D cross-point accelerator Optane module is so amazing that it can make even this mid-2000s style beauty fly. Well, let's see if it can. Browse privately and securely with TunnelBear, the simple VPN app. Try TunnelBear for free at the link in the video description. All right, so what do we got here? We got B250 motherboard, the most generic RAM ether, WD Black, Core i5-7500, yeah, okay, whatever. Let's skip all over that. Let's get straight to the Optane Memory Series Optane module, whatever. Let's skip over to this thing. So this is a fundamentally new type of computer memory. It's different from both NAND flash and DRAM, offering up a lot of the benefits of both. So lightning fast latency and lower cost than system memory, and lower cost than system memory. Okay, here, let's just pull this out. With the ability to retain the data without being constantly powered on like this stuff. You can actually learn more about 3D Crosspoint in a couple of videos that we've done in the past, which you can check out in the cards up there. Okay, so the way this is supposed to work, why am I holding this, sorry. The way this is supposed to work is kind of like Intel's SRT technology of yesteryear, where you would take a small SSD and you would like bolt it to a larger hard drive in order to accelerate your operating system and frequently used programs. The difference though, is that in the last 7 years, we've gone from 32 gigs of NAND flash being a reasonable cost to achieve this functionality to 32 gigs of Optane, which Intel is boasting at the cell level is up to 1,000 times better in terms of access latency, which should translate to dramatically improved system responsiveness. Okay, so for starters, let's get the module back in there, get this baby fired up. Get this baby fired up and validate Intel's claims the way the product is intended to be used. So an Optane module with a mechanical spinning hard drive, probably shouldn't have been knocking on that. So in terms of benchmarks, we used PASSMARK's DISKMARK, ADOBE at a variety of queue depths, boot times, and Grand Theft Auto 5, since its notoriously long loading times are the bane of the existence of gamers who really play a lot of Grand Theft Auto 5 everywhere. But come on, you guys! This is Linus Tech Tips! You don't want to see me test the Optane module the way it's supposed to be used? The way Intel expects us to test it? We need, here, hold on. Let me get one of these out of here. Ah, yes! We need an SSD. I mean, by my logic, if an SSD could accelerate a hard drive, because it's a lot faster with much lower latency, then an Optane module should be able to accelerate an SSD. I asked them about this at the super embargoed event, and they refuse to answer me, opting instead to stick to the marketing message. Well, I'm not gonna accept that. I've got the hardware in my hands. There's nothing that would prevent me from testing this. So let's shut this baby down the manly way. That's right. And fire it back up with one of these and have a look at some numbers here. Before we can evaluate whether Optane can accelerate the SSD, we need to get a baseline reading for the SSD in all those same performance benchmarks. So it's a Kingston SSD Now KC400 1TB, and you can see here, we've got all of our numbers run now, and Intel Optane memory is disabled. Now this is really important. We enable it by clicking Enable, then Yes, and then it takes a couple of seconds here in order to prepare the system, copy some files, whatever the case may be. Okay, there we go. So now what we need to do is run all of our benchmarks a second time to see on our clean Optane run if there's any improvement. And the numbers are pretty much the same, but we were expecting that. Optane, like any caching solution, works by watching data access patterns over time and then using the knowledge that it gains to predict what data the user is going to need in the future. So then, what we needed to do was run an entirely new round of testing to get a second run of data to see what our module learned the first time around. And this time, now we are looking at a significant difference. And by significant, I do mean in the scientific sense, not in the sense that in real-world applications, the average user would actually notice it, since the Optane acceleration of an SSD was only really noticeable in synthetic benchmarks. Okay, so it's conclusion time then. That was a lot of fun, but I think we uncovered the reason why Intel doesn't want people talking about accelerating an SSD with an Optane module. If you want greater than SSD performance, there will actually be full-on Optane SSDs for enthusiasts coming in the future. But for now, I'd recommend at the price that they come in at, so 40 bucks or 77, depending on the capacity you choose, I'd recommend sticking with the way Intel's marketing them as a way to accelerate a mechanical hard drive for a system that otherwise wouldn't be able to achieve that level of responsiveness. It works like SRT, but thanks to the improved responsiveness, we did notice a tangible difference day to day, just launching applications and navigating the operating system from having the Optane module installed on our drive. Is it worth the 77 bucks for the top of the line one? It's hard to say. Like so many things in life, I guess it kind of depends on your priorities, and that's where Intel has lost me a little bit on this one, because they are limiting compatibility with Optane memory to 200 series chipsets with Kaby Lake processors and up. So most of the people that Intel's trying to sell an accelerator module for a hard drive to have a brand new system, and I would question why exactly it is that they don't then have a boot SSD for that aforementioned system. But I'd love to hear that I'm wrong. Let me know, you guys, based on what you know now, that Optane is flippin' cool and that it really does work, do you see this as a valid way to use your system, or would you just kind of go, you know what, I'll use one of these until I can get a much bigger one of these? You know what's awesome? Home-cooked meals. You know what sucks? It's actually the worst part, is like thinking about what to make and shopping for the ingredients. If only there was a solution to, all right, Blue Apron! Blue Apron delivers all the farm-fresh ingredients you need right to your doorstep in exactly the right proportions, so there's no trip to the grocery store and no waste from unused ingredients. They're delivered in a refrigerated box, so everything is fresh even when you're not at home when your package arrives. And their whole vision is to develop a more sustainable food system through sustainable fishing, responsible farming, and reducing food waste. They've got two types of plans, the two-person plan and the family plan, and there is no commitment. You can skip or cancel the service at any time. And the first 100 people will get 3 free meals on their first Blue Apron order using the link in the video description. So thanks for watching, guys. If you enjoyed this video, then you can click that like button. I mean, there is also the other one, but come on. And if you really enjoyed it, you can get subscribed. You can check out where to buy the stuff we featured at the link in the video description. And you can check out both our merch store, which has cool shirts like this one, and our community forum, which we will also have linked, you know, down there, if you know what I mean. I'm always watching out of the corner of my eye for the camera person to cringe. Then I know I've delivered it just right.